let's start discussing on Java or Java things. So, Java 7, you said you worked on Java 8, you didn't work, right?
Yes.
So, Java 7, can you explain me like dynamic and static polymorphism?
Yeah, so basically.
What are the difference?
Yeah, so dynamic polymorphism is deciding which method we have to call during the runtime, okay? And static polymorphism is like like JVM will decide on the compilation time that which method it will going to call. So static polymorphism within the it will happen within the class having the same method having the same name, but return type and the parameter we are passing is different. And for dynamic polymorphism is like using the it will use the inheritance concept like superclass and subclass having the same method name with the same signature and same parameter.
Okay. Suppose you have a string, and the string from the string you have to get the third non-repeated character.
Third non-repeated character.
Yes. So you can take your name like Preeti.
Yes.
From here, P is the first character which is non-repeated. R is second character which is also non-repeated. This is R is the second non-repeated character. Then comes E is repeated one. Skip it. Then T. T is the third non-repeated character here.
Yeah.
Similarly, if you pass any string, it will give you the third non-repeated character from the string. How do you get? What logic you have to do?
Okay, let me think. We can use the hash map here.
Okay, how do you use?
Suppose we are splitting the Preeti and we'll make it as a character sequence we are using the string character sequence.
Are you writing something?
Yes.
How do you explain?
So I'm just writing the summary here. So by using the split method we will get the character array and it will be the string Preeti. Okay, so and now we are using hash map here. If to store the key will be the string and integer for having the character sequence number of occurrence, okay, and then we will check either Preeti we will check here if Preeti is in the hash map then it will be create the counter 1++ and we'll just update the value here, and if it is not there then we will store in the character sequence after looping the Preeti string dot length we'll check that which character having the occurrence when. And by that we can have the third character which is non-repeated.
But hash map doesn't maintain order. How do you get the third non-repeated?
Yeah. So if it will not sort the order, we are using the for loop to make the character sequence. So when we will ओके व्हेन वी गेट द थर्ड कैरेक्टर, व्हेन वी गेट द थर्ड नंबर, थर्ड कैरेक्टर व्हिच आर एंटरिंग इन द हैश में विद द ऑकरेंस वन, देन एंड देन वी कैन ब्रेक द फॉर लूप ऑल्सो. वी कैन यूज द ब्रेक यूवर टू ब्रेक द फॉर लूप ऑल्सो.
So how to get the third non-repeated character? You are putting in the counter count, I mean frequency in Hausmann. Hausmann doesn't maintain order. How to get the third?
We can use linked Hausmann pair if. To maintain the order, we can use linked Hausmann.
So, what are the difference between linked hashmap and hashmap?
Hashmap, you said that it will not store in the order way, but linked hashmap it can store in the order way.
Okay, so you have a sentence, and the sentence has multiple words. And you are going to reverse the sentence, but keeping the space as it is. Like you should not change the position of the space. You have to preserve the space where those are there. Like for example, my input will be say I am Preeti. And I'm going to my output will be I. Then this is my output. Sorry, yeah, this is my output. Space should be preserved.
The space should be preserved, but.
But this sentence should be reversed. The sentence you have to reverse. By preserving the spaces.
Okay. I got it.
How to do that?
Wait, I'm just.
No need to write anything. Just tell me, like that's fine.
I think we will iterate the string and will ch if what to say, like I is the last index, so we will change into the first index and replace. We will take as a temporary character variable, and we will replace by using if we will, I will match first and last index, like I and I and n minus 1, n will be the length of the string, okay, and n minus 1 will be the last index, okay, and I will by using the index of we will sorry by using the replace method I can replace, or by using the third temporary variable I can replace I can switch the first and first and last character, then I plus 1 if it is space, then I will continue, then if it is non space thing, then like it is I 3 in second loop it will be 3, then I will check second index because I minus 1 already changed. Wait. You if it is a space you have not you must I am P R you change the space value also, no? Okay, so if it is a space, then we will skip and then we'll go for I plus plus, and then for I plus plus means third loop, but still there will be I minus sorry n minus 2. N will be the string length. N minus 2 means second what you say, the second last. Yes, we can do like that.
I didn't get you, like what you are saying.
I am taking the for loop.
We have to reverse means like last to first here.
Yeah. We have to in for loop what I will do, if index character, if string dot I index of I sorry what index I means a character sequence I having the character value, then we will replace it by using the third character value, third variable, sorry, by using the third variable. I take I and n minus I. N minus I will give me the last in last value, what is the last character value of my string, and I will give the first character value. Okay, so I will interchange both, and after that in second loop, if n if I having the second value and n minus having the second last character, I will get, if second value having the space, then I will not change or replace its position. I will just I will just skip it, and then I plus plus, then third in third increment I will get the A. Okay, but my n minus 1, when I will but my n minus 1 will not there, it is n minus 2 still it is there. So I will replace n plus I will replace I plus 2 with the n minus 2.
Okay. So suppose you have an array list and you are going to hello?
Yes, yes.
You have an array list with the employee objects and you are going to sort the array list based on employee name and descending order. How do you sort?
In descending order. We can use the comparator.
Yeah, you have an array list with employee objects.
Yeah, we can use the comparator object. Yeah, we'll create the comparator class which will extend the comparator, and then we will pass the employee list, employee object, and we'll check the attribute value, that employee dot what you say by age, by its age.
By name.
Yeah. So if we'll check if employee dot name having the character sequence name having the what you say, A, like start with A or next will be start with you, according to that we will sort the employee object. We can sort the employee object in array list.
Okay. How do you remove duplicate employee object based on employee ID from the array list, same array list?
Okay, so we can iterate the value if it is, we can create the second array list also if it is there. Hello.